All right, now come to the next and very important pathway of biochemistry section. This pathway is very important for our life, and this is gluconeogenesis. Before going into the depth of this pathway, first let us understand the meaning of gluconeogenesis. What does it mean? Gluconeogenesis means the formation of glucose from non-carbohydrate source. Formation of glucose from non-carbohydrate source, like from amino acid, from fatty acid. So this pathway basically is functional between meal, when we are not taking meal, when we are fasting, and our body needs some glucose, and to make this glucose from non-carbohydrate source, this pathway is going to take place. So you can say that this pathway is very, very important pathway, and it takes place in two parts in our cell, in mitochondria and in cytoplasm. In mitochondria and in cytoplasm, and it is basically the reversal of glycolysis pathway. In glycolysis we have three irreversible steps.
Yes.
This pathway is glycolysis. Glycolysis, and this pathway, glycolysis means the breakdown of glucose for the formation of energy, for the formation of ATP. And it happens when we take meal, when we take carbohydrate. So in this pathway, glucose is broken down into the final pathway product, pyruvate, and this pyruvate is further metabolized in our body. But to understand this pathway, these three important steps we have to recognize in this pathway, which are the irreversible steps. And by irreversible we mean that in these three steps it requires energy, it uses ATP, and we cannot reverse this pathway. So the first one is this pathway, this step, which convert glucose into glucose 6 phosphate by the help of enzyme hexokinase and glucokinase, and it consume on ATP. So this is the irreversible step. First step, irreversible step. The second step, in which fructose 6 phosphate is converted into fructose 1,6 bis phosphate by phosphofructokinase 1 enzyme, and this step also require an ATP, so it is also irreversible step. And the third step is the last step. Phosphoenol pyruvate is converted into pyruvate, and it requires ATP. It is also an irreversible step. So gluconeogenesis basically means to reverse this pathway, to make glucose from pyruvate. But to make glucose from pyruvate, we need to overcome three irreversible steps. This step, from pyruvate to phosphoenol pyruvate, from fructose 1,6 bisphosphate to fructose 6 phosphate, and then glucose 6 phosphate to glucose. So you can say that gluconeogenesis is the reverse pathway of glycolysis. It makes glucose from pyruvate, but it has to overcome three irreversible steps. First, second, and third step. Now come to the gluconeogenesis pathway. This pathway, as I already mentioned, that this pathway occur in between meals, when we are fasting, when we do not have glucose. So we have to make glucose for our body to keep working. And this glucose is made from non-carbohydrate source. Three main sources we have for this pathway. Number one is lactate. Number two is glycerol 3-phosphate. And number three is alanine. Alanine, you already know, it's an amino acid, and glycerol 3-phosphate come from the fatty acid, and lactate, it comes from the anaerobic cells. So alanine is an amino acid, but alanine is not the only amino acid which is used for gluconeogenesis. We have total of 20 amino acids, and among 20, two are purely ketogenic, lysine and leucine. These two amino acids are ketogenic. We cannot utilize these amino acids to make glucose. The rest of the amino acids, 18 amino acids, are gluconeogenic, and some are gluconeogenic and glucogenic, ketogenic as well. But the core point is we can use 18 amino acids, the rest of the 18 amino acids, to utilize in this pathway for gluconeogenesis. So three main substrates which we can use for the formation of glucose when we are in between meals. Glycerol 3-phosphate come from the fatty acid. Lactate come from the anaerobic cells when we do not have enough oxygen to utilize the glycolysis pathway. And the third pathway is amino acid. So basically from fatty acid and amino acid. Now come to the main pathway. You already know that pyruvate was the last substrate or the last product of glycolysis. These pathways start from the pyruvate, and pyruvate is converted into oxaloacetate with the help of an enzyme called pyruvate carboxylase. Carboxylase means addition of carbon dioxide, but this enzyme or any other carboxylase enzyme, it requires three substrates: A, B, C. A for ATP, it utilizes an ATP. B for biotin, vitamin, and C for carbon dioxide. So pyruvate carboxylase convert pyruvate into oxaloacetate. But this pathway is initiated, or this enzyme is activated by acetyl-CoA. Acetyl-CoA is obligate activator of pyruvate carboxylase. If acetyl-CoA is not present, this pathway will not work. So acetyl-CoA, and where this acetyl-CoA is coming from? These acetyl-CoA come from beta oxidation of fatty acid. In our body, when we are starving, when we are not eating something in between meals, our fatty acid, which is stored in our body, in our adipose tissue, it broke down into acetyl-CoA, and then this acetyl-CoA then activate pyruvate carboxylase to convert pyruvate into oxaloacetate. Now these pyruvate come from three sources: alanine, lactate, and glycerol 3-phosphate, the non-carbohydrate source. So the first step was conversion of pyruvate into oxaloacetate, and acetyl-CoA not only activate pyruvate carboxylase, but it also inhibit PDH, pyruvate dehydrogenase. What does PDS do? Basically, this pathway basically convert pyruvate into acetyl-CoA. When we have excess of glucose in our body, and we know that glucose is metabolized into pyruvate, and this pyruvate then by the help of pyruvate dehydrogenase is converted into acetyl-CoA, and this acetyl-CoA then go into the cytoplasm to go into multiple pathways. It also go into the fatty acid synthesis. So this pathway, then when we have deficiency of glucose, this pathway, the fatty acid again broke down into acetyl-CoA, then this acetyl-CoA activate pyruvate carboxylase and inhibit PDH. Now pyruvate is converted into oxaloacetate. This oxaloacetate cannot go into the cytoplasm from mitochondria. To deliver this oxaloacetate to the cytoplasm, we use a shuttle. Our body, our cells use a shuttle called Maillard shuttle. By this Maillard shuttle, oxaloacetate is delivered into the cytoplasm. Now in cytoplasm, one more important enzyme or step is PEP, carboxykinase, phosphoenol pyruvate carboxykinase. It convert oxaloacetate into phosphoenol pyruvate. This is the second important step. The first one was this step. The second one is PEP carboxykinase. And this enzyme is activated by our hormones which is present with between meals, like glucagon and cortisol. These hormones are released between meals, and these hormones activate genes for PP carboxykinase, and this PP carboxykinase use an GTP and convert oxaloacetate into phosphoenyl pyruvate. Now phosphoenyl pyruvate is converted into glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate by irreversible steps. These are not important steps to discuss. Glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate is then converted into fructose 1,6 base phosphate. Here comes another important step, and this step is conversion of fructose 1,6 base phosphate into fructose 6-phosphate by the help of an enzyme called fructose 1,6 base phosphatase. This is the rate limiting enzyme of gluconeogenesis. Rate limiting enzyme means we can change the fate of this pathway by controlling this enzyme. Like this pathway is activated by, this enzyme is activated by ATP and inhibited by AMP and fructose 2,6 base phosphate. Now here come an interesting question. This pathway gluconeogenesis happen between meals when we are out of ATP, when we do not have energy, we require energy in our body. So, but this important enzyme of this pathway is activated by ATP. ATP is an energy form. So, this pathway also requires energy. This question is where this energy is coming from to run this pathway, because we do not have energy. We do not have glucose in our body. For this pathway, we are making glucose. The answer to this question is this ATP comes from the fatty acids, from the beta oxidation of fatty acid. This stored fatty acid in our body, they broke down and they form acetyl-CoA and they form ATP to run this pathway. So gluconeogenesis is an energy requiring pathway. Now fructose 1,6 bis phosphate is converted into fructose 6 phosphate by removal of 1 phosphate molecule by fructose 1,6 bis phosphatase. Bis phosphatase means those enzymes which remove phosphate. So fructose 6 phosphate is then converted into glucose 6 phosphate. The last step, also important step, is conversion of glucose 6 phosphate into glucose. And then this glucose is ready to deliver into the other tissues of the body, because this pathway gluconeogenesis occur in liver. An important fact is liver synthesize glucose, but itself do not utilize this glucose for energy source. I repeat, liver do not use this glucose which it makes itself. It deliver this to other tissues of the body which require this glucose for the ATP formation. And this pathway, this step requires an important enzyme called glucose 6-phosphatase. It convert glucose 6-phosphate into glucose, and this enzyme is only present in liver. So in summary, gluconeogenesis is an important biochemistry pathway which happened between meals. Alright, now come to the next and very important pathway of biochemistry section. This pathway is very important for our life, and this is gluconeogenesis. Before going into the depth of this pathway, first let us understand the meaning of gluconeogenesis. What does it mean? Gluconeogenesis means the formation of glucose from non-carbohydrate source. Formation of glucose from non-carbohydrate source, like from amino acid, from fatty acid. So this pathway basically is functional between